This is the award-winning Lee Pitts Live.
Brought to you by the North Law Firm. For accidents and negligent security cases, call Joe at 239-337-1191. By Southwest Florida Crime Stoppers, where you can report crimes and get paid with nobody knowing your identity. Call 1-800-780-TIPS. By Solomon's Air Conditioning Incorporated. No matter what the weather is outside, have it your way inside. Call 239-693-1569. By Regions Bank. And by Lee Health. All right, Southwest Florida, welcome back to Lee Pitts Live. We're so thrilled to have here in the studio for the first time. He's the man that's keeping the arts flowing in the River District here in Fort Myers. The famed Florida Repertory Theatre puts up some fabulous shows. You guys know I got a chance to go out there a year or so ago to Fences, and we had a ball out there as well. My good friend Greg Longenhagen is here, the artistic director. Greg, welcome to Lee Pitts Live, man.
Thanks, Lee. It's great to be with you.
Good to get you to be on the other side of the camera and behind the scenes and see what we actually do out here in the field, man. Thanks for coming out. We're going to find out all the great things that are going on. Before we do, Attorney Joe North, a famous attorney in the area, he wants to keep everybody safe, and he's sent this for you, a nice mask.
Oh, that's beautiful. Thank you, Joe.
All right. Just sit that right there and keep up the good work, Joe. First of all, what is the Florida Repertory Theater?
Lee, we are a professional regional theater right here in the downtown River District. We're also a 501c3 not-for-profit organization. We're an equity theater company. A lot of people don't really know what that means.
Talk to me.
Equity is the professional union that sanctions actors, stage actors, and stage managers here in the United States. Also in England and in Canada. But it's one of the things that separates us from the other theaters in the area.
Okay, that's a good thing, sounds like.
Yeah, I mean, there's lots of great theater here. Ours is an equity theater. It means that those artists that work at the Florida Repertory Theater, the actors, are in the union. Not everyone that's on the stage is union, but we have to meet a quota. We have to have a certain number of union members there. And generally what happens is when you go to the union, you get a higher quality performer. You get somebody who has worked at it for a long time, somebody who does it for their career. It's not just a side job. It's not just for fun. It's someone who is a professional artist.
And I tell you, when you come to the Florida Repertory Theater to see a live performance, it is top notch. Every time I've been there over the years, it's always spellbinding. Tell me before I go down these fundamental questions, tell me about the pride and the detail that you guys place and bring in Southwest Florida. High level. I feel like I'm on Broadway when I'm there.
Well, I love that you said Broadway, because this is what we pride ourselves on. We call ourselves Broadway quality theater right here in downtown Fort Myers River District. And how we do that, Lee, is we go to New York City several times a year. We look for talent in New York City. We also have an ensemble of artists, not just actors, but stage designers, lighting designers, costume designers. They're all part of a group. And we've been working together for 23 years now.
Mm-hmm. Now, when I come into the theater, it's always the stage is, you know, first class, whatever the scenes are you guys are doing. I also feel like I'm going back in history. I sit in these nice cushiony chairs. It's small enough to feel intimate, big enough to get a nice crowd in there. There is some historic value to that Florida Repertory Theater, isn't it?
Absolutely. The historic Arcade Theater was constructed around the turn of the century. It was originally a space for live shows.
I got you.
Yeah. Comedians, magicians, they did plays there. It was a place for live performance. It was converted to a movie house for a long time. It only ran for live performances for maybe, I think, 2 to 3 years. And then it was converted to a movie house, ran as a movie house for a long time. And before my time here, Lee, it kind of fell into disrepair a little bit. And then it became rejuvenated back in 1997 when Florida Rep was born. Right down here in downtown Fort Myers.
And I noticed when I walked down the hall, they have a smaller theater in there. And that's really nice as well. And I've seen pictures and photos over the years, and people seeing photos now of children coming there during the summer or something like that. I want you to elaborate. I want you to mention that other theater down the hall, what its purpose is, and talk about opportunities for children with your arts.
So we have two performance spaces. One is the historic arcade theater. It seats 393. Then we have the art stage studio space. And we do all different kinds of plays and musicals in both spaces. The art stage studio seats about 116 at max. One of the things that is really, really wonderful about Florida Rep is that we serve so many children in the community. In fact, we don't have the numbers from this year because of COVID, but the previous year, over 45,000 children and their families. 45,000, Lee. And that's kids who come to our art programs in the summer, our intensive summer program camps that we have. That's our conservatory audition-only programs that we have. That's our camp mini stars for the little ones. Mm-hmm. And then we also tour around to schools all over Lee County, and in fact, the five-county area.
Now, I know you don't like to, like, represent yourselves as all of that, but I want to represent you as all of that. I know there are other theaters around here. There's nothing close to the Florida Repertory Theater. What are you guys doing in terms of the COVID-19 situation right now in its limits?
I'm so glad you asked that, because this is a hard time for arts organizations everywhere, all around the country. And we really have pivoted, if you will, to moving to a virtual format. So we have all kinds of programming. In fact, more programming than we have ever had before. Now, we are looking at trying to gather outside. I'm working on Florida Rep Outside, where we can bring people outside, mm-hmm. socially distanced, to be in an environment. We have the space to do it, and they can take in a show, a shortened down show, because it is outside. And
we're outside right now, just giving you some concept, right?
Go ahead. So it's beautiful right now. The wind is blowing. We're at that time of year, the time of season, mm-hmm. when we all want to be outside. And we know that the community is really hurting for some live performance. It's been a long time, and we feel that this is something we can do moving forward.
Outstanding, man. Now, we are right here in the heart of the Dunbar community on Henderson Avenue at the Lee County Black History Museum, Martin Luther King Boulevard. I know that the Florida Repertory Theater has done a yeoman's job in reaching out to all of the community and exposing them to the arts. Talk about some of the things that you do to encourage and get the Dunbar community, the African-American community here, involved in what you're doing.
Yeah, that's great, Lee. We've done a lot over the years. We do go into the schools, as I said, with our TYA tours, or Theater for Young Audiences tours. We've gone to Franklin Park Elementary for many, many years. We go to Dunbar Middle. We probably get about 40 kids every summer, roughly 40, because we track it, right? We track what neighborhoods kids are coming from. We want to know that information.
Great.
Yeah, we get about 40 from this community that come out for our summer programs. And, we're constantly reaching out, always looking to get, because part of our mission is to reach everyone with the arts. And our doors are wide open. We want people to come in mm-hmm. and enjoy. And we're proud of the work that we've been doing in the
and
community.
And we're showing your website on the screen throughout the process, and people can go there and always keep up with what current events. I know it's always good, too, to when the opportunity comes to purchase tickets, to purchase them in advance, it's always good to get an idea of what your seating is going to be, right?
Yeah, you know, on a normal season, we have shows that will sell out, actually, mm-hmm. and we've done it where we've had to add shows, and we're very happy to do that, Lee. Right. We love when we can add shows mm-hmm. To the run of a particular title. So uh-huh. yeah.
And you got a chance, I think, during Fences. I've been a lot of places and seen a lot of things and done a lot of things and been in front of a lot of different audiences. But when you called me up on the stage doing Fences, and I felt like I was an actor, I was up there at the opening of Fences, man, that was one of the highlights of my life, man. I appreciate you giving me the opportunity to come up there on that stage and address the that large audience of people there.
Lee, you were great. And you could tell how many fans you had in the audience that night,
nice,
because everybody
turnout.
Knew who you were,
right.
And people were psyched to see you come on stage. I was so grateful for you joining
us.
Yeah,
we got to partner on something like that in the future as well. Let's go to do you do tours like of the theater itself, if people want to just come and do a tour of the theater?
We're not really a presenting organization, so we really don't bring in too many organizations. Pretty much everything you see on our stages, Lee, is built in-house.
Right.
Everything, the costumes, the set, anything that you see there is done in-house. So we're not really a presenting organization like some other houses maybe in the area. We build everything, it's all handmade, and we do it from scratch.
The life of the River District, downtown Fort Myers, a lot of that life that has become so outstanding over the years, not talking about pandemic time, but we know what it was, and it's going to get back to that. Many people have said that the Florida Repertory Theater was a huge contributor in making the downtown River District the entertainment place that it has become. Your thoughts?
Lee, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, I would say that Florida Rep has been the anchor tenant. It's really what turned downtown, the historic River District, around for all of us. You got to look at it like this. We bring in, now with our two spaces, sometimes 550, sometimes 600 people coming into downtown 8 nights a week. Now, when they leave that theater or before they get to that theater, where are they going? They're going out to have a drink. They're meeting friends. They're going to have dinner. They're going to have lunch. We have really been an economic driver in downtown.
And now you got that big hotel, the Illuminary there, and just the convention center. It's just going to be even more spectacular. As soon as this pandemic gets going out of the way, we could just take advantage of all that, right?
Lee, from your mouth to God's ears.
I want you, I don't want to mess up any names, but I've interfaced with at least four people over there, three or four people on a regular basis. I want you to call their names, get them on TV.
Absolutely. So you're talking about probably Renee Pesci, right? She's been with us. Probably Jason Parrish.
Of course, Jason, shout out.
Yep. John Martin, our executive director. And you probably have talked to Brendan Powers.
Exactly.
Who's our outreach. Yeah. So all those folks.
We're making y'all famous. Well, man, I can't wait to get you back in here again. And next time we're going to have you guys design us a set. And somewhere down the road, though, we have to get this set on your stage. Let's make that happen.
You got to time
that out right. Greg, it's been a pleasure. Keep up the good work, okay?
Thanks a lot, Lee.
As the saying goes on this particular show, for those who say it can't be done, they're usually interrupted by those like Greg and all the fine people at the Florida Repertory Theater. We're doing it. We'll be right back.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, Southwest Florida. Thanks for watching Lee Pitts Live. Of course, I'm Lee Pitts. I hope you enjoy that particular show. But you can always catch us here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button down there. That way you can get your Lee Pitts Live on demand when you want it and how you want it. We also encourage you to watch our show on Fox 4 and connect with us on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live.